今天要来跟大家介绍一下国外的一个红药丸频道。那这个频道在今年忽然窜红，这个频道名称呢叫做 Just Pearly Things。
My dad is like a top 1%.
If I didn't talk to him, I might
40% of women that
still be in that like super toxic relationship
get abortions have had two or more abortions.
My dad is a very unique person.
Can you let me finish? My goal is to get married.
We're gonna turn 304s into wives.
My life, like, it wouldn't be complete if I didn't have a husband and family.
其实这个频道我大概是去年的时候就关注到他，那时候还没有什么人在看，但是在今年他忽然开始窜红。那有更多人开始注意到他了。那为什么他的频道会红呢？特色是什么？今天这个影片就是来跟大家讨论这件事情。他的内容形式，我觉得最受欢迎的大概有三种。第一种内容风格是一个他频道偏早期的风格。那基本上呢，他就是找他的朋友来一起来看这个红药丸相关的内容。
Jess is going to be doing a new series on my channel,
yeah,
where we show her red pill content, and you guys are going to slowly like watch her get red pilled.
Should be fun.
So, what do you know about the red pill?
I literally know nothing about the red pill.
那这种内容就是所谓的 reaction video， 这个其实在 YouTube 生态里面是一个非常常见的一个内容的形式。那基本上就是大家想要看到这个影片里面某个人的反应。那么他其实就想到这个 idea， 就是如果我找一个在 Blue Pill 时期还没有看过这些 Red Pill 的这些朋友来看看，然后让大家看看这些人被拔管的过程以及他的反应。那么有趣的是，他也不会只是找一些他的这种好朋友啊，一些比较安全牌的朋友，他有时候也会找一些极左女权人士一起来看这些红药丸的内容。
So guys, you already know the deal. I show feminist Jordan Peterson and I get their reaction.
I'm saying that 9% pay gap exists.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's a gap between men and women. I'm not saying why it exists, but it exists. Now,
yeah,
if you're a woman, that
seems
pretty unfair.
You have to say why it exists.
But do you agree that it's unfair? If you're a woman...
Not necessarily.
And on average, you're getting paid 9% less than a man. That's not fair, is it?
It depends on why it's happening.
Okay, what do you think?
I feel like she is putting a lot of words in his mouth. Like, he's not even being given an opportunity to actually explain himself.
Mm-hmm.
And she's already jumping to conclusions saying, well, it's because you don't want to side with women. But he mm-hmm. hasn't exactly implied that.
Mm-hmm.
But so far, he's...still making sense to me.
Yeah, well, it's interesting because you kind of thought before my show, right, you thought that the wage gap existed, right, because of sex.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like he said, I think it's because I'm viewing it and like just based on gender.
Yeah, well, it's okay. I think we're taught that from a young age. Yeah. I think a lot of girls think that.
接下来他频道的第二种内容形式，那这个内容形式也是他的主打。那基本上就是他会找一群人哦，原本他只找朋友，但没有，现在找一群人，让大家开始来辩论。
He shouldn't have to do that.
I'm not saying he should.
So my point is, even if you get pregnant, right?、
Mm.
Should you have a right to not be a mother? Why doesn't he get a right not to be a father? So baby's coming.
Mm-hmm.
You can get an abortion or you can keep it.
But then don't sleep with her if you don't have the intention of like.
Don't sleep with him.
Yeah, no, like, it's true.
Because I could use the same argument that pro-life people use.
Yeah, but I'm not saying that like, you're wrong about women.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just saying it works both
yeah,
ways.
If you don't want to have a baby with somebody,
don't sleep with them. If there's a
yeah.
chance that the condom's not、
yeah.
going to work or she's going to get pregnant, don't do it. The、
but、
same with the woman.
If she's pregnant,、mm-hmm. the baby's、mm-hmm. already coming. She has a choice. He doesn't. Why is that fair?
Every single pregnancy isn't a choice, which is why things like
that. Well, it is true, because sometimes、
yeah.
you are.
It's
not everything、
yeah.
isn't all roses.
Are you talking about grape? Is that、
yeah.
what you're talking about? That's less than 1% of abortions. That's 0.5%.
那么这样的讨论跟辩论其实也很有看的，因为平常可能大家理论看一看，有些人可能自己也没有多少跟女人相处的经验啊，没有这些人生的经验值。那他如果找这些男人女来。虽然说多少还是有一些相机啊，有这个镜子在前面，真实度有多少，可能也没有到100%的真实。但基本上，当大家吵起来啊，辩论起来啊， 就是大底上人人还是会掀出一点自己的底牌。
Respectfully, I know men are better than women at sports. Sorry, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. You're probably you specifically, you're probably better than most men, but in general, like most men in the NBA can dunk, WNBA can't.And they get paid more because they make more money. Like women's NCAA has been at a loss for years. They don't even make money.
Why is that? Because
people don't watch as much because it's just not as entertaining.
那么有趣的是，它的一个特色就是说，它其实会找很多数据。它基本的套路就是它让在场的来宾就是先吵一吵架，这个吵完然后那个吵，然后他就旁边在那边主持嘛。那吵到一个地步的时候，可能吵到这些极左女权可能已经。露馅了，那这时候他就会，开始拿这些数据去打他们的脸。
The man leaves. The man is nowhere to be seen. He's disappeared.
Statistically, that's not true. Women leave 70-80% of the time. I'm pretty sure now it's 80%, and if you're college educated, it's 90%.
再者，还有个看点是因为她本身是女性，所以她有个女性 buff 加持，也就是说她在跟这些女权啊、极左在吵架的时候。啊、因为她本身是女人嘛，所以相较于如果是其他男人跟她辩论的话，这个 pro 是女性的时候，她自动就会让对方的这个火力减一。
If you can't generalize at all, then you can't argue anything.
Yeah, there are always
exceptions. I'll
take that back, and I will just say you can't generalize men and women and families.
那最后一个内容形式，她最近才开始推出的内容形式，就是所谓的街访。
So today we're asking the question.It's her body, her choice, right? We have the right not to be mothers, right?
100%, yeah.
So,
I was about to say I've got a strong opinion about it because I don't really want kids, and I can just imagine like how horrible it would be if you don't have a choice to, get rid of the baby.
So the question is, should men have the right then not to be fathers? So if a woman gets pregnant and he says, I want to renounce paying child support,Would you support that? So he can sign off all of his rights.
And leave it with the mother.
Yeah, because we get the right to get rid of the kid if we want. Shouldn't he have the same right in the name of like equality?
That's a tough one because I guess that would be fair because it's the same as the mum giving up the child, but then it's not really in their body. So I don't know how different it is really.
So, because the problem we're having is it incentivizes women to get kids off of rich guys.So, for example, the NBA has issued statements telling players to flush their condoms because girls will steal them because they know if they get a kid off of them, they're entitled to child support for 18 years.
Oh, I see. Okay. I didn't know that.
Yeah. And even Drake, I don't know if you heard about when he put hot sauce in his condom.
I don't know.
Yeah, the girl tried to sue him over it.
Shit. That's crazy, actually.
Yeah. So it's like when we're seeing things like that, it begs the question, like, should men have the right not to be a father too? And you would say...
Yeah, 100%, to be honest. Yeah.
Okay, well, we agree then. Thanks for stopping.
那么有时候他有遇到一些疯子来去跟他乱飞啊。
The chances are, I will just go on a fucking course, I will go work with someone, I'll just fall asleep in front of them, and they will rape me. Because the chances are, they will rape you. It's not all men. Do you wear a t-shirt underneath there that says, I'm not gonna rape you? Have you got a t-shirt saying, I'm not gonna rape you? No! Are they? Are you wearing a t-shirt saying, I'm not gonna rape you? No! No, because people don't wear them t-shirts saying, I'm not gonna rape you. And the chances are, the lads that say, I'm not gonna rape you, are the fucking ones that will! So...
Why are you laughing?
So,
I need you to stop, like, you're being very aggressive.
Not all men, though.
Because it's not all men. You realize, like...
Why are you acting that?
Because you guys are acting crazy. You're acting crazy.
There you go. Let's massage the man's ego. Let's massage the man's ego.
Why do you think the lads are crazy?
Why are you doing it? Fucking give me a
reason. Because you're not entitled to security walking home alone at night. If you're in a big city, like, I just wouldn't walk home alone at night.
It's not that he's holding on.
Pearl 这个人其实蛮有趣，他的本名叫做 Pearl Davis， 那他现在是大概25岁、26岁这个年纪，他兄弟姐妹大概有10个左右，所以是一个大家庭。
My family is here. Ah!
在他爸爸可能就是开始忙工作忙事业啊，因为是大老板，所以他母亲就变成一个全职的家庭主妇。那据他所说，他的兄弟姐妹啊都很有成就，可能就是各行各业的这些翘楚，但他一直就是没有找到他自己的定位，所以他开始看到 YouTube 有这个 Rapio 的这个事业上的机会的时候，他就是会紧紧的抓住。那么在他频道才刚开始还根本不红的时候啊，他其实也算蛮认真，因为他有找一些前辈去咨询，像他就有咨询这个 Kevin Samuels。据他所说，他当时还在一段关系里面有个男朋友，然后他说那段关系很糟糕啊，然后那时候他自己的自信心很低落啊。Kevin Samuels 跟他讲说，你现在正抓好的一个事业的机会，你的频道大有前途，所以请专注在这个地方。再来 ，Pearl 他在去年，就是2021年，大概7月、8月的时候，他有上过这个 Fresh and Fit 的节目。
So my name is Pearl.
Hey, welcome.
I'm 24. I do YouTube full time, so my channel is just Pearly Things.
有趣的点是，他在上完那次的节目之后啊，他的频道开始就出现我刚刚讲他的第二种内容型，他的主打就是请一堆人来辩论的这个情形。所以就我的看法是，他那一次去 Fresh and Fit 的这个节目，除了本身只是单纯去参加，也本身可能也是一种商业考察，去看看说他是怎么做这个节目的。那么我相信他其实可能为了经营自己的频道，还咨询了更多更多的人。比如说他后来我也看到说他其实有去咨询过一个叫 Roommate 叫 Hafiz 这个人，在 Manosphere 也是一个蛮有名的人物。当然这个很多个 beef 啦，我这样讲他会离题。最近这个 Pro 跟这个 Roommate 的 Hafiz 又掀起了一个这个八卦出来。
So let's play your game. I love to play your game.
I'm not trying to. I'm sorry. Okay.
I'm playing. I'm having fun. Okay. Don't worry. You're content creator. We're having fun. We're having fun. Come on. Are we good?
Yeah. We're
okay.
Good.
We're having fun. Okay, okay. Game is just a word. Okay.
Okay.
Guys, we're having fun.
He kept saying like, let's not play these games. And then I would say, what games?I'm not playing a game. And then he'd be like, oh, I'm just talking. Like, this is how I speak. And I'm like, huh?
Pro, 他其实这个频道他并不是一个人经营的。那就我的观察，他背后应该是有个团队在经营这件事情。因为他曾经有讲过，他自己也知道自己是很情绪，他很讨厌下决定。那他很多频道上面的一些决策都不是他自己决定，都是其他人帮他决定好，让他去做的。
A lot of content creators are afraid to outsource things, and I am a big fan of outsourcing.
再者，他的频道可以在串红，很大原因就是他的这个团队知道怎么去经营他的 YouTube 的影片的标题跟缩图。OK， 只要你是一个专业的 YouTuber， 你在这边玩过一阵子，你一定会知道说缩图跟标题的重要性。那么 Pro 他频道的缩图我觉得还 OK， 中规中矩，但是他的标题确实是有下过功夫，很多标题都非常的耸动跟直接啊。那么再来，他其实上传影片的这个频率跟数量是非常非常的大量的，基本上他有时候一天会上传个就是5-10个影片都有可能，就是超多。那么他本身是以长内容为主嘛，所以他的长内容之后，他的团队会帮他剪很多短影片，然后就拼命的上传。那当你的频道有这个超大量的影片上传之后，这个 YouTube 演算法自然就会 favor 你一些，会多推送你的影片。也因为如此，他现在这频道已经受到越来越多人的关注了，也开始有人在讨论他。那么我观察下去，我发现他后来开始在经营之后，我已经分不太出来说他到底是真实的想法居多呢，还是商业操作的手法居多。因为他就是大量的这个曝光嘛，然后一直聊天，一直聊，一直聊，一直聊。虽然说他的商业上面的这个考量跟他真实上考量可能可以是看在一起， 但无论如何也造成说他慢慢的也会出现一些比较有争议的言论，像他最近一个争议性比较大的就是他直接公然说他认为女人不应该有投票权。
This is Pearl's world. I'd ban birth control. I think that's the root of all evil. And I'd actually go further. I don't think women should vote.
Lord Jesus, keep on going.
Yeah, that's
no,
it.
Women, you can't vote. No birth control. Yeah, keep it going.
I know, because it's always freedom without responsibility. And
I
so,
love
like,
it.
The
women
reason,
should not vote. No, Pearlie said it herself.
I'll tell you why, though. I'll tell you why. Because it's freedom without responsibility.
I love
and before
this.
Women, like, like I believe in consequences for your decisions. So the men know if they vote someone batshit crazy into power, you guys get drafted. We don't. Women decide elections. We're 55% of the population. I think if we want to vote, equally draft us. Y'all want equality. And personally, I don't want to get drafted, so I'll be in the kitchen.
他认为投票权，当初男人可以投票的原因是因为男人也要去被抓去当兵，有义务要当兵去服役报效国家。那么相对于其实女人其实是大部分是没有这个义务的嘛，所以他认为说，因为他不想当兵。他不想要去被抓去服役啊，去战场或什么之类的，所以他认为说，那我也不要投票。那我的认知是，其实红药丸他应该是处于在两性动态领域里面。当我们在讲男女不同啊，或什么之类的，我们讲的不是一个基本人权上的不同。你投票权，然后你有什么自由言论权，这些东西是一个身为人的基本的这种权利啊。我不认为男女要标准不同。而在此我也认为说 Pearl 他反对女人有投票权的这个说法，看似是觉得说啊，他觉得他不想当兵，就是啊，我不想被抓去当兵，所以我就反对女人有投票权。那我觉得这个理由有点牵强，这个大局观不够。你反对女人有投票权原因是因为你自己本人不想要当兵，我认为这个理由不够，对不对？所以这个也是他最近一个争议性很大的一个话题啦。那那个阿爸跟 Preach 也有去就是批评这件事情。
And I had to cringe so incredibly fucking hard because I don't think people realize how crazy red pill folks sound when they say stuff like this and how easy it discredits them. I think people should bring back slavery because I was like, what? I think women should lose the right to vote. And I think also they should lose the right to some of the biggest invention that brought us to this current age right now. People want to just get rid of because what?A lot of these folks enter this red pill space and they'll say like, oh, we're not misogynist, we're not misogynist. We're not anti-women, not type of... You should lose your right to vote. And you should lose your ability to have contraceptives. What?
我认为他本来是很令人敬佩的啦。毕竟虽然说这中间很多是他自己商业上的考量，他要拼事业，但是他毕竟还是站出来去面对，去跟这些女权吵啊，然后去街访啊，去面对对疯子啊。虽然说他旁边有敌人在保护他，但毕竟他还是要站出来嘛，去挡这些子弹嘛。那我也认为，因为他帮很多人挡子弹的原因，所以他也会有这么多支持者，这原因是其来有之的。所以整体来说，我认为这个频道很不错。就是如果你是一个新手，那你英文也 OK， 这是一个蛮。这个怎么讲？新手 friendly 的一个频道。好啦，那今天这个影片就到这边结束啦。那基本上，如果你想要了解更多的这个红药丸的内容啊，你可以去下面的链接下载我的红药丸的电子书。那么当然，我还有另外一个这个内容是有关经营这个自媒体的，叫做《选择你的现实》。如果你对这个东西有兴趣的话，不然像我今天跟你分析这么多，就是一些基本的自媒体经营的知识，你也可以去。下面加入这个选择的现实免费的课程 ，OK， 你可以了解一些人家经营自媒体的内容。那当然，如果你想要更多内容的话，你也可以加我的黄金订阅 ，OK， 就是有更多私密内容都在这个里面，好不好？所以如果今天这个影片帮到你的话，请帮我点赞、分享给你需要的朋友。那么我们就下次见啦，拜拜。